You need a first-hand knowledge. Because a second-hand knowledge just won't do. And when you get that first-hand knowledge, you'll have a knowledge of God's hand. I wish I could preach. I'm coming to a close even now. I'm bringing this message to a close. When you have a, watch this, everybody. Don't worry about it. The Holy Spirit is trying to speak conversion to somebody's life right now. See, when you have a first-hand knowledge and not a second-hand knowledge, you know about God's hand. Can I talk about God's hand for a little while? Joshua said that God delivered him by his hand. Isaiah said God's hand was not so short that it couldn't save. Peter was sinking down in the water one day and he cried out. He said, Lord, save me. And immediately, what did I say? Immediately, the Bible says Jesus stretched forth his hand and pulled him up out of that water. When you got God's hand, David said, in there are new mercies every day. When you got God's hand, you know that no hand against you shall prosper. When you got God's hand, you know that no matter what the doctor say, no matter what the boyfriend does, no matter what the bill collector says, no matter what anybody says, your first-hand knowledge of God's hand will pull you through. A little boy was frequently meeting with a wise man in the wilderness. I'm closing. He was meeting with a wise man in the wilderness quite often, and he would always ask the wise man questions, but the wise man always had the right answer. And so one day, the young man was running out to meet the wise man. He saw a bird laying on the ground. He got an idea. He snatched up the bird and began running, looking for the wise man. As he was running, looking for the wise man, he concocted a scheme. This was the day he was going to stump the wise man. Carried the bird in his hand ever so carefully. He got to the wise man thinking, oh, today I'm going to stump him, for I'm going to ask him what's in my hands. He ran through the forest looking and screaming, wise man, where are you? And so finally the wise man said, here am I. He said, wise man, what's in my hand? And looked at him and looked at his hands and said, a bird. Now see, the little boy anticipated this. So he had formulated a second question. The second question was, is it dead or alive? You see, if the wise man said that it was dead, he was going to let it go free. But if the wise man said it was alive, he was going to crush the life out of it. He had it all planned out. He said, wise man, come on, is it dead or alive? Come on, wise man, is it dead or alive? He could barely contain himself. He said, you already guessed what's in my hand, but now answer my second question. Is it dead or is it alive? The wise man stopped and he said, no, don't stop. Answer me now. Come on, hurry up, answer me. And the wise man just looked at him in his eyes and said, simply, it's in your hands. Brothers and sisters, first-hand or second-hand knowledge, your ability to change that is in your hands. Mm-hmm. Now you can crush the life out of it. Mm-hmm. Or let it fly. Mm-hmm. But at the end of the day, it's in your hands. We're praying, church. Father in heaven, I pray that someone under the sound of my voice allow the Holy Spirit to work on them. I pray that someone under the sound of my voice, Father, is now going to look for a first-hand knowledge and stop relying on the elders. Stop relying on the pastors. Stop relying on the deacons, but go right to the well from which, if you drink, you will never thirst again. Mm-hmm. And that is Jesus. That is Jesus, the one that you sent to die for me on Calvary Street. That is Jesus, the one who shed his blood for me that I may, even though I am sinful, go free. Jesus. Jesus. The name by which men may be saved. And so I pray, Father, that in this congregation, not only this day, but today will be a beginning of reformation and truly desiring not a concept or a doctrine called the Holy Spirit, but a relationship with Him.
Yeah.
And this is my humble prayer in Jesus' name. And everyone that agrees said,
amen.
And said again,
amen.
And said so the people could hear it far off,
amen.
Hallelujah. Glory to God.
No.